Hi, everyone. Hope everyone's having a great day so far. So welcome to my talk, Living on the Edge, Boosting Your Jamstack Site Performance with Edge Functions. A little bit about me, as Phil has said. My name is Erica. I am a senior software engineer at Netlify working on the frameworks team. If you enjoy this talk, I like to blog, and you can also contact me at my site, ericapisani.dev. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So a lot of the marketing around Edge Functions has to do with how it helps address issues of performance bottlenecks and high latencies for users in certain parts of the world. But in order to understand how Edge Functions help address these issues, we first need to take a step back and understand what is the edge in Edge Functions. So to do that, I have to take a quick step back and do a quick data center organization overview. Don't worry, I know y'all didn't come here for that. This will be very brief. But on the broadest possible scope, most cloud providers have these organized by region. So think your US East 1, your Canada Central. And within each of these regions, there are multiple availability zones. And when we talk about an origin server, it is usually hosted at one of these availability zones. And the edge are data centers that live outside one of these AZs, with an edge function being a function that is run on one of these data centers. Pretty straightforward. You might also see the term points of presence or edge locations to refer to these. It just depends on the cloud provider that you're working with. There we go. So just to give a sense of just how many more edge locations there are in the world relative to availability zones, I borrowed this from AWS's documentation just because that's what I'm more familiar with. So all the yellow dots here represent availability zones. And when I go to this next map here, you can already see a lot more dots. I'm just going to quickly jump to the next map, the next slide, so you can see them side by side. There we go. So you can see at a glance that depending on where your users accessing your site are based out of, if you're able to leverage edge locations to fulfill some of your most highly trafficked pages or requests, you can significantly improve site performance. And I'm particularly looking at regions like South America, Africa, and Australia, where they have one availability zone. And if you have a user that's maybe on the other end of that region there, they're going to experience some really high latencies. And having an edge location help handle these requests will make a big difference. So to see where edge locations fit into this, a client will make a request. The edge location that is closest to the user making the request will be the first spot that starts handling it. Now, the best possible scenario is that an edge location can handle the entirety of the request. But let's say that it can't for whatever reason. It'll continue on that request to the origin server. The origin server will handle that request, send a response back to the edge location. Now, what's really cool here, and there's a lot that you could go into here, but just to touch on it, there's a lot of caching opportunities at edge locations. So at that point, let's say you're serving localized content, for instance. You can cache that localized data at that edge location before sending the response back to the client. So now that we've touched on that, let's look at a quick, common Jamstack case study, transforming a server-side rendered page into a static one. Now, why would we want to do that? Well, a server-side rendered page runs, built, it's hitting the origin server every single time. So if you have a very highly trafficked page, that's a lot of load you're putting on the server. And if you can change it into a static page, that means that you can cache it on the content delivery network or CDN for faster access. So in our use case here, let's imagine for a second that I have a thriving e-commerce business. I've changed my day job from a software engineer to running an e-commerce business. I have a simple Next.js site, and I have a page that most of the users on my site will see. In some cases, let's say my customers are in the EU, I might need to display a GDPR banner. I have a sale maybe in a certain country or a certain city, or I just want to say hello. So what I have here is, on the left-hand side, some middleware that is running on the origin. I'm getting the geo object off the request. I'm getting the country off the geo object. Adding that country value to the URL before rewriting the response. And then on the right-hand side is the page. It is a server-side rendered page because of the presence of get server-side props. I'm getting the country off the query, and then based on the value of that country, so specifically Canadians, or someone in Canada, I'm going to give them a promo code to get a sale off their order. And then otherwise, it's just a friendly hello world message. At that point, the HTML that I would be sending back to the user gets rendered, and then send that back to the client. So as mentioned before, the server has to render every single one of these requests. This is not cached on the CDN. You could get around this for much, much smaller sites where you maybe have different static pages that you have for different regions, but that can get out of hand very quickly as soon as you start getting a bit of a bigger site. So that brings us to our static and edge functions implementation. So you'll notice immediately that the middleware function got a little bit bigger. The stuff that existed in get server-side props has now been pulled into there. One thing that is not obvious in this code here is that the middleware is now running on the edge. So to walk through this, we have, once again, the first two lines are the same, getting the geo object off the request, country off the geo object. The next two lines there are a little bit different. The const request equals new middleware request. I am leveraging in on that particular line Netlify's enhanced Next.js middleware. I'll get back to that in a second because I'm going to spoil the ending if I talk about what it's doing right that second. And the next line after that, await request.next, what's happening there is the middleware is making a request to the origin server. But in this case, it's not actually hitting the origin server, because as you'll notice on the right-hand side with the e-commerce page, it's now a static page, so it's cached on the CDN. So it's getting the cached asset back from the CDN. So at that point in time, the response is actually the page with a Hello World banner. But if it's a Canadian customer, it still needs to show that the promo code. So based on the value of country, what I'm doing at the end there, and this is where the enhanced middleware comes in, is I am going to replace the text of the HTML and update the page prop before that gets sent back to the client in the end. And as I mentioned before, you can cache these things at the edge. So now I have a localized version of the site that is available for users that are in that area that would likely also want that exact same page to be served to them. It's really cool stuff, right? So now that we've covered kind of a simple use case there, how do edge functions compare to the origin functions that we are more familiar with? Edge functions are expected to run often, potentially on every request. Some common use cases for them beyond serving localized content are user authentication and A/B split testing. And the way that cloud vendors keep these things a bit more performant is they restrict you a little bit with lower CPU time. Now, I say that it varies wildly depending on the vendor. I've seen as low as maybe 15 or 30 milliseconds to as high as 15 minutes. So this entirely depends on your use case. I highly encourage you to do more research here, but I'm just making a general note that lower CPU time is available. And what this means in practical terms is that you can do less operations within that function compared to your standard origin function. And last but not least, there's limited integration with other cloud services. So going back to AWS as my example, because again, that's what I'm familiar with, Amazon advertises about 200 AWS services that integrate with standard Lambda, but there's much less for edge functions. So in a Jamstack case, I'm not sure necessarily what people are maybe invoking their standard Lambda methods with other services, but it's just something to note in case this does apply to you. So we've just touched the tip of the iceberg today in terms of edge capabilities by looking at a simple use case of serving localized content that went from being served by the origin server to being served on the CDN and at the edge. We're starting to see the rise in popularity of edge-first frameworks like Fresh or frameworks that support edge like Remakes. We're handling at the request at the edge is increasingly becoming the preferred default rather than handling them at a potentially very distant origin server relative to our users. And an edge-first future is exciting because the more requests and data that you can serve closer to your users, the better the experience of your site will be regardless of where the user is based in the world. And in Jamstack sites, edge functions play a big role in moving towards that edge-first future. So thank you so much, everyone, for coming today and for your attention. I hope you enjoyed it, and it's encouraged you to maybe take a look at edge functions for your site.
Nice job.